most part, we don't hear a whole lot about the blood of Jesus. We don't hear a whole lot about Calvary's cross. I'm not saying that no one is teaching it. I'm not saying that we're the only church that's teaching that. Please don't pick that up. But what I'm saying is what we see from mainstream Christianity on television, we don't hear a whole lot about the blood of Jesus. It's all about how can I improve this? How can I improve that? How can I get better at this? How can I get better at that? And I share with First Lady McGee that once we understand and have a revelation of the blood of Jesus, all those things that concern us will get better.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Oh, glory to God. Understand and have a revelation of the blood of Jesus. The new house don't come without the blood. The promotion don't come without the blood. The money don't come without the blood. So you've been going after stuff and not the blood. So now the scriptures teach us, First Lady, that we're supposed to have faith in the blood. Not faith in your own identity, not faith in your own education, not faith in who you know, faith in the blood. Everything that the blood of Jesus has already done for us, we have to have faith in that. Hallelujah. This is why the devil fights this message more than any other message. He doesn't want you to understand about the power of the blood. Let me give you three reasons to have faith in the blood of Jesus this morning. Three reasons. They all start with the letter A. Give you some A's to help you remember. Number one, we have atonement through his blood. Here's the first reason why we, the New Testament church, are supposed to be having faith in the blood of Jesus. It's because we have atonement. Everyone shout atonement.
Atonement.
Come on, shout atonement.
Atonement.
We have atonement through his blood. Atonement. Remember our opening scripture used this big fancy word called propitiation.
Yes.
Y'all remember that?
Yes.
Everyone say propitiation.
Propitiation.
Come on, shout propitiation.
Propitiation.
Man, I like that word. Real big word, kind of scary if you're not careful. Propitiation. The word propitiation simply means atonement. Atonement. And so let me give you this definition. It's a little lengthy, so let me read it to you two or three times. Propitiation simply means atonement. And atonement, theologically, it is the doctrine concerning the reconciliation of God and mankind that is accomplished through the life, suffering, bloodshed, and death of Jesus Christ. That's what propitiation, Jesus was the propitiation, my brother, for our sins. He was the sacrifice for our sins. The shedding of his blood was not for him, that was for you. That was for me. And so it simply means theologically the doctrine concerning the reconciliation of God and mankind that is accomplished through the life, suffering, bloodshed, and the death of Jesus Christ. I love that. Under the old covenant, the blood of goats and bulls were used to cover the sins of the people. That's so interesting, and we'll look at this in just a few moments. Under the old covenant, we would call that Old Testament. Under the old covenant, the blood of goats and bulls were used by the priests to cover. Everyone say cover.
Cover.
Come on, say cover.
Cover.
It was used to cover. Notice I didn't say cleanse.
Yes.
It was used to cover the sins of the people, Mother. And it only lasted for 1 year.
Yes, sir.
So the sins of the people, after the priest would go into the holies of holies and make all the sacrifices, so forth and so on, the blood of those animals, it just covered. Everyone say covered.
Cover.
It just covered the people's sins for 1 year, my brother. It didn't cleanse it. It didn't eradicate it. It didn't remove it. It just covered their sins for 1 year. Okay? Go to Hebrews chapter 9. Hebrews chapter 9. And remember, this is how we can tell love. God loves coffee because he brews. You thought she was the only one brewing. Hebrews chapter 9. Hebrews chapter 9. Faith in the blood. Faith in the blood. Faith in the blood. Faith in the blood. Blood, blood, blood. Boy, I'm so tuned into this message, I put my red cover on my iPad.
Oh,
Hebrews chapter 9. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're going to fall in love with the blood of Jesus. Praise God. Hallelujah. We love him. We thank God for him shedding his blood on our behalf. Hebrews chapter 9. Shout amen when you're there. Look at verse 11, please. It said, but Christ being come a high priest of good things to come by a greater and more perfect tabernacle, not made with hands, that is to say, not of this building. Verse 12, neither by the blood of goats and calves, but by his own blood. But by his own blood. He entered. Now watch this now. We got to pay close attention to this. Neither by the blood of goats and calves, but by his own blood, he entered in how many times?
Once.
How many times? The priests, they would take the blood of goats and bulls. Our high priest, elder and eldresses, Jesus, our high priest of the old covenant, their high priest would take the blood of goats and bulls and go into the presence of God and offer the sacrifices for the sins of the people to cover their sins for 1 year. But Jesus, being our high priest, took his own blood in one time, and that was it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Unlike the blood of goats and bulls that merely covered the sins of those under the old covenant for 1 year, under the new covenant, we receive the total forgiveness and cleansing from our sins because of the blood of Jesus. So under the old covenant, they had to have their sins covered every year. But under the new covenant, our sins have been cleansed one time because of the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's go to 1 John chapter 1. 1 John chapter 1. Hallelujah. So here's the first reason why we should have faith in the blood. We have faith in the blood because we have atonement through his blood and by his blood. In other words, we have the forgiveness of sins. Hallelujah. We have the forgiveness of sins. I don't know about y'all. That's good news. That's good news. Yeah. Y'all sitting here like y'all been holy all y'all. That surely wasn't pastor. I thank God for what God is doing with me now. But man, I remember what I used to be. I don't know about you. I thank God for the blood. Man, I thank God for the blood. Whatever whole lot of stuff that I did that's covered by the blood, that's cleansed by the blood, it's under the blood. The devil can't use that against me anymore. Focus on what you used to be, what you used to do, how you used to act, who you used to run with. He wants you to stay in the past, but once you got born again, all those sins have been placed under the blood. Hallelujah. Word of God. So now I have faith in the blood. Faith in the blood. Faith in the blood. John chapter 1, look at verse 5. 1 John chapter 1. Look at your neighbor and say, it's under the blood. 1 John chapter 1, look at verse 5. It says, this then is the message. First thing, Magee, I love the way this starts off. Brenda, I love this. This then is the message. In case you don't know what the message is, the verse starts off with, this then is the message. Man, I love that, sister guys. This then is the message. Watch this now. This then is the message which we have heard of him and declare unto you. What is that message? That God is light, and in him, that's Jesus, is no darkness at all. If we say that we have fellowship with him and walk in darkness, we lie and do not the truth. But if you walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another. Watch this. And the blood of Jesus Christ, his son, cleanses us from all sins. Cleanses us. Not covers us. Cleanses us, my brother. Not covers us. Cleanses us. Not covers us. Cleanses us. is us. Man, I gotta say that to you. Get that in your spirit.
Yes, yes.
Not covers us, cleanses us.
Yes.
The blood of Jesus, my brother and sister, it cleanses us.
Yes.
The blood of goats and bulls, elder, can only cover.
Yes.
But the blood of Jesus, elders, it cleanses. It cleanses us. I've been cleansed. You're looking at a cleansed man because of the blood. Hallelujah. I love this. Verse 7. But if you walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another. And the blood of Jesus Christ, his son, cleanses us from all sins. Good News translation of verse 7 says it like this: but if we live in the light, just as he is in the light, then we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus, his son, watch this, purifies us from every sin. The blood of Jesus cleanses and purifies. Y'all hear this morning? The blood of Jesus cleanses and purifies. The Bible in verse 7 says it like this: but if we walk in the light, God himself being the light, we also experience a shared life with one another. As this first lady purges us all our sins. Purges all our sins. Purges. Y'all know what purge means? Y'all know what purge means? Get rid of it. Get rid of it. Get it out. Get it out of you. The blood of Jesus purges our sins, Simon and Mary. It gets the sin out of you. You know, it kind of reminds me of that old stain remover years ago called Shout. And when you had a stain, you would just shout it out. The blood of Jesus, it just pushes out the sin that's in your life. Man, am I the only one excited about this? Well, I'm so excited about this. I'm going to have to keep preaching this message, go home, accept the invitation myself. Glory to God. Hallelujah. The blood of Jesus purges out the sin. See, this is why I no longer like to do the things I used to do. Run with folk I used to run with. Hang with folk I used to hang with. Because the blood of Jesus purged all of that about me. Hallelujah. Come on, let's give the Lord a hand of praise for the blood. Glory to God. Colossians chapter 1. We're talking about faith in the blood. Faith in the blood. Hallelujah. Colossians chapter 1. Thank God for a new house. Let's get the blood first. Thank God for more money. Let's deal with the blood first. Hallelujah. Because without the blood, none of that stuff is possible. Colossians chapter 1. Y'all feeling this like me? Colossians chapter 1. Let's look at verse 12, please. Colossians 1, verse 12. Hallelujah. We're still dealing with the atonement. Colossians 1, verse 12. This is why we have faith in the blood, because we receive atonement through the blood, okay? Or the forgiveness of sins. Watch this. Colossians chapter 1, look at verse 12. It says, giving thanks unto the Father, which has made us meet to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in light, who has delivered us from... Well, let me go back. I tried to keep moving, but this verse says, say something about me. Verse 12, giving thanks unto the Father, which has made us meet to be partakers of the inheritance, watch this, of the saints in light.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Saints. Saints. Those of you that are born again, you're called saints. Not ants. Saints. Who has delivered us from the power of darkness and has translated us into the kingdom of his dear son. Watch this, verse 14. In whom is Jesus? In whom we have redemption through his blood. We have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sins. So the forgiveness of sins comes because of the blood of Jesus. So the reason why we have faith in the blood is because we have received atonement because of the blood. Our sins are forgiven, Deaconess, because of the blood. I love that. It is only through the shed blood of Jesus Christ that mankind's sins are forgiven.
Yes.
So the only way that your sins are going to be forgiven, if you came in here this morning as a sinner, you say, Pastor, well, what is a sinner? Let me help you out. A sinner is one who practices sin.
Amen. That's good.
You practice sin.
Amen.
See, a saint doesn't practice sin. A saint falls into sin. But a sinner sins. That's the nature of a sinner. Just like the nature of a dog is to woof, 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 woof. And the nature of the cat is to meow. And you can tell a dog, well, I don't want you to woof, 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 woof. I want you to meow. And no matter how hard that dog tried, he can't go against his nature. So the dog saw. Because he can't go against his nature. A sinner is a sinner because of their nature. A sinner practices sin. A saint doesn't practice sin. We fall into it. So it's only through the shed blood of Jesus Christ that mankind's sins are forgiven. So if you came through the door this morning as a sinner, I'm going to give you the opportunity in just a few moments to be a saint. And I don't know about you, I wouldn't come to a service like this, hear a message like this called Faith in the Blood, and hearing that Jesus was the sacrifice or the propitiation for my sins, and still walk out a sinner.